Welcome to Attenuation Nation. I'm Lance Cape.
And I'm Ben Radius. Our topic today is Corning Cable Systems' performance at NABCAR 50 micron bend cup.
And it was a huge day for cable with the National Association for Battling Cable Attenuation Rates, also known as NABCAR, put it on its toughest challenge, the bend cup.
That's right. And while the competition was fierce, I have to say that Corning Cable Systems really brought their A game.
Ever since they developed the now industry standard loose tube cable design more than three decades ago, Corning Cable Systems has maintained a reputation for pioneering cable innovation. Several years ago at NABCAR's OSP event, they left their competition high and not so dry when they introduced the industry's first gel-free cable. So, did they struggle with the competition this year, or are they turning this hallowed event into a mock-competition?
It's definitely a one-company event. Corning Cable Systems threw down the gauntlet again, this time with the unprecedented announcement. They're powering all of their landscape solutions 50 micron cables with bend-insensitive ClearCurve Multimode Fiber.
That is a bold play, and I'd say it's anybody's guess whether that can pay off for them.
You tell me, Lance, because at this year's Bend Cup, their landscape solutions 50 micron cables took first place, breezing through each challenge with the lowest attenuation.
And I don't know why anyone would be surprised. Nobody does it better. Tell us more about what you know about their win, Ben.
I'd be happy to. But first, let's make sure everyone understands the course that the cables face today. It's a challenging one, but not radically different from what these cables face in everyday use. Take a look at the housing door these cables had to tackle. Imagine being pinched in one of those.
Ouch.
Then it's off to tie wrapping, or as most of our contestants affectionately call it, torture testing. If a cable could cry, this is where you'd see it happen. Some knucklehead cinches it extra hard with a tie wrap. I've seen this part of the course take down even the most experienced installers. And finally, the death spiral, where each cable must perform the deceptively simple mandrel wrap maneuver. Lesser cables simply break under the stress of this one's, Lance.
Ouch. Begging the question, are these supposed to be fiber optic cables or contortionists?
Nowadays, Lance, with the moves, adds, and changes that most cables face, both.
And so you're going to stand there and tell me the Landscape Solutions cable team made it through that convoluted mess unscathed without any performance-enhancing drugs. You really believe that?
Are you kidding me? Best attenuation rates hands down, my friend, and the best performance under pressure I have ever seen. And because they're using ClearCurve Multimode Fiber as their standard for their 50 micron cables, they don't even need to consider performance-enhancing drugs. Even bigger, they're harnessing that power for every cable in their fleet.
I call shenanigans. Standard, as in no special part numbers, no mail-in coupons, no ridiculous premiums in order to get it.
We don't need no stinking coupons. Absolutely. Standard, like bald on Lance. That's right, I said it.
I can't believe you went there. But that's almost unfair. Can you imagine what that type of change can do for installers using Corning Cable Systems cables, or for those challenged souls who don't? Will NABCAR really sit back and just let this happen?
It really is paradigm shifting, Lance, and without a clutch. In addition to knowing their cable can take on the slings and evils of a typical network install, they also know that no one beats Corning Cable Systems on availability. So when they need it, they can get it fast. Take a look at their distribution network. They're everywhere.
And that's critical when speed of delivery is a factor.
And when is it not?
Exactly. Okay, stat boy, what did we miss?
There's been some controversy over people saying they're buying Corning products and them not working correctly. What do you guys say to that?
Well, if that happens to you, look at the side of the cable. Do you see the words Corning Cable Systems optical cable on it?
What if it says Corning on it, but not Corning Cable Systems?
It sounds like they bought a product made with optical fiber, manufactured by Corning, but cabling done by someone else. And while lots of cablers can use Corning optical fiber, the only way to be sure you're getting the easy cable prep and clear curve multimode fiber performance standard is to buy from Corning Cable Systems.
The next time you're purchasing cable, look for Corning Cable Systems optical cable printed on the jacket. It's the only way to guarantee that your cable is 100% Corning from the optical fiber to the jacket, and therefore the only way to know you're getting the performance Corning Cable Systems promises with its cables.
And keep in mind, when you buy from Corning Cable Systems, you're also automatically getting award-winning customer service and support that can help you out over the phone, online, or by sending someone to your job site.
But I gotta say, Putting Corning optical fiber in someone else's cable is like putting a jockey on a dog in a horse race. Network reliability is dependent upon cabling because it's what protects the optical fiber from the environment it's running in. Without quality cabling, the fiber can't do its job properly, and outages may occur. And without service and support, installers can't do their job either.
Well, that's all the time we have today, knuckleheads. Congratulations to Corning Cable Systems, the NABCAR champions. To explore everything Corning Cable Systems has to offer and discover a distributor near you, visit corning.com/cablesystems.